The Canon R5 Mark II had generated a lot of buzz lately, especially around its impressive low-light video performance, with some rumors even suggesting it features a triple base ISO system, just like that C400. But is that true to the hype? In this video, we will conduct an in-depth ISO and noise test to identify the exact base ISO numbers that deliver the best low noise, high dynamic range footage. We will also compare C-Log 2 performance on the R5 Mark II versus the R5 C right here in C-Log 3 to see if there is a significant advantage. Additionally, we will carry out a real world overheating test at 8K 60 frames per second RAW to determine the exact overheating limits and how soon we can film again after overheating warning. Let's dive into the data and see how the R5 Mark II truly performs. Hey, welcome back, it's your boy Hugh here. We are in the middle of testing the Canon R5 Mark II for immersive filmmaking on the Apple Vision Pro. If you want to catch the latest results, tips, and tricks in real time, be sure to follow me on Instagram as well. I will be sharing updates on my story, so don't miss out. If you watch my secret 2024 highlight shot on the Canon R5 Mark II, you likely noticed its impressive low light performance. But the question remains, is it better than the professional level cinema camera, the Canon R5C right here? Does it have dual base ISO like the R5C, or could it even have triple base ISO like the C400? Unfortunately, Canon hasn't provided any official information, and unlike the R5C, the R5 Mark II does not have dual base ISO setting in the menu. So to get the bottom of this, we have to run a test at every single ISO with the exact same exposure. To save you time, here are the results across all ISO in Canon C-Log 2. It is tough to spot noise in a well-lit scene. At first glance, even ISO 25600 looks usable. Impressive work, Canon. With the dual fisheye lens, we have a good black spot to really showcase sensor noise. So here is the detailed comparison across all different ISOs. ISO 800 provides the cleanest result, which is expected and should be your go-to setting most of the time. However, unlike the Canon R5C, ISO 3200 still show quite a bit of noise. Interestingly, ISO 4000 is much cleaner. This suggests that the R5 Mark II might have at least a dual base ISO, with the second low noise ISO at 4000, higher than the R5C 3200, making the R5 Mark II potentially better in low light. Here is a side-by-side comparison at ISO 3200. The R5 Mark II shows similar noise performance to the R5C, but at ISO 4000, the R5 Mark II is significantly better. So for extreme low-light situation, setting your ISO to 4000 will give you the best result. What about triple base ISO? At ISO 12800, we don't see a significant noise reduction that you expect from a C400. Instead, the noise increased as the ISO climbed past 5000. So it is safe to say that the Canon R5 Mark II does not have a triple base ISO. While this might be disappointing, at least now you know what you expect. One standout feature in the Canon R5 Mark II is the inclusion of C-Log 2. For immersive filmmaking, especially when shooting outdoors with a fisheye lens, managing bright skies and harsh lighting is crucial. This is where C-Log 2 truly shines. It gives you at least 2 additional stops of highlight retention, making a significant difference in your final image. Let's compare. On the left, we have the Canon R5 Mark II using C-Log 2, and on the right, we have R5C with the C-Log 3. Both cameras are set up with identical settings. Notice how the sky in the R5C is completely blown out, while in the Mark II, you can still make out the sun. Now, when we apply the CMT709 conversion LUT, you will see that even the cable detail vanished in the R5C shot. The loss of detail in the R5C has always been a frustration, but with the beautiful C-Log 2 support in the R5 Mark II, that issue is now solved. Of course, overheating has always been a hot topic, no pun intended, when it comes to the R5 series. Unfortunately, the R5 Mark II still struggle with this in 8K 60 frame raw recording, which is pretty much the go-to mode for immersive filmmaking targeting a platform like the Apple Vision Pro. So let's do a real world test in my studio, putting the R5 Mark II against the Canon R5C right here with external PD power to see how they handle overheating in practical scenarios. Both cameras are using Angelbird AV Pro CF Express B card. The studio is set to a controlled 74 Fahrenheit temperature. The Canon R5 Mark II overheat and stop recording right at the 17 minute mark. Before it stops, we measure the exterior temperature at about 107 Fahrenheit. Not scorching, but certainly hot. We restart the camera immediately and, as expected, the temperature rose rapidly. The temperature quickly entered the red zone and the indicator began to flash. At the 1 minute 30 seconds mark, the camera shut down again. We restart the recording immediately once more, but this time we only got 50 seconds before it overheat again. After giving the camera 1 minute break without removing the battery or the card, we managed to record for 2 minutes and 8 seconds additional time before it shut down again. So yes, the R5 Mark II does overheat and it can interrupt your filming. However, with some patience, you can restart and keep going, and the wait time isn't too long. It's manageable about 90% of the time. But keep in mind, overheating isn't the only challenge in this mode. And 500GB card only give you around 24 minutes and 18 seconds of total recording time. Your storage will run out quickly as well. So planning your shot is crucial. This is where your AD or director comes in, but they need to be aware of this limitation. Storage is expensive and your camera has a heat limit. So careful planning is essential. Despite the limit 18 minutes of filming time, the R5 Mark II offers significant advantage over the R5C. It can film 8K 60 frames per second without needing an external power source, making it ideal for mounting on a lightweight gimbal or even handheld in locations where professional camera might not be allowed, like the Louvre in Paris. Speaking of which, check out our new 8K 60 frames per second immersive 180 experience of the Louvre on your Apple Vision Pro or Meta Quest 3 to see what is possible with 3D immersive filmmaking. The R5 Mark II isn't meant to replace the Canon R5C. Instead, it is a lightweight, travel-friendly alternative that runs on mini battery. It packed with quality of life feature, including machine learning based 16K upscale and a built-in VR preview feature for on-set reviewing. I dive deep into each of these features in my full Canon R5 Mark II review right here. So be sure to check that video out to see why I believe the R5 Mark II is probably the best VR 1D camera you can buy. If you are new here, subscribing and hitting the notification bell would mean a world to us. It helps us continue to bring you high quality content. I filmed this video just 3 hours after getting my two poops and I'm still on painkillers right now. Your support helped me push through and keep creating. So go watch my Paris immersive 1D video now. Thank you for being part of this journey with us.